But it was, I wrote it around Memorial Day, so it's probably going to get a Memorial Day type title. But for you guys, okay, go like this.
Papa, could you stand over there because the light is much better.
Oh, okay, yeah. Am I standing in the key?
Yes. Better, better, yes.
So I don't know its title, but this is a short poem. Then I'll read you the one I came here to read. Okay. A black man, otherwise strong and fit, sits rolling around in a wheelchair. His legs cut off at the knee. His prosthetic legs kept in a plastic I Love New York shopping bag, strewn with stickers and decals. U.S. Army, American, POW, IMS, support the troops. Inquires of an African merchant's sidewalk stall, do you have American flags for 99 cents, the big ones?
Beautiful.
Excellent. Wow, great.
Okay, and this I wrote for Janine.
And it's about our poetry readings, right?
I wrote this for Janine. I started it last year when we were all waiting for the poetry reading to happen. That didn't happen, but kind of happened. So here it is. And so then I started working
on it. So what happened last year when it happened? It didn't happen, but kind of happened.
It's in the poem.
Oh, okay, gotcha.
Okay, too much fodder. Okay, it's called Silent Memorial on Willow Pond, because that's what we call these readings, right? There was no poetry reading on Willow Pond last year. No. It rained all day and thundered and lightning cracked the sky and gray was the color of the day that day. No. There was no poetry reading on Willow Pond last year. Instead, we observed the silent tears that fell from heaven upon the grass to proclaim at last the loss of poet Janine Pomni Vega. Not being here, but being over there somewhere. Today, the morning dew collected upon the leaves of grass as Tovey wailed on his alto sax on the lazy porch of Joel and Dee Dee's commune, where sat Daniel de Solar in his own sun the last time we would ever be with him. And there was a woodpecker looking for breakfast in a tree. While we all searched, while we searched all day for Andy, the poet Clausen, thereof, their love, we know not of, the poetry of casual conversations, as we waited to hear the poem that we wanted to hear, that we needed to hear, that life account that only he could tell, though we know well the transition is personal and in the public domain of friends, as you, our friend, transcend into the ages. All the elements of nature gathering in the garden were arranged in their display of silence, in the sublime message of a breeze caught within the wind upon the human ear that reminisces upon a memory that brings someone so far so near to you through nature that all that you can do is think how miraculous all forms of life are in their form of life. And thus perhaps the reason why we step into the forest to witness that the tiniest resembles the enormous. Oh, all the weeping willow trees disagree. There was a poetry reading on Willow Pond last year. Thus as it was a command performance conducted by the late poet Janine, her spirit now among the fractals of nature's union with itself. And here it was that she were here and there at once. Whenever and wherever she wanted to be or not to be, without questioning a poet. And we discovered Andy was at Naropa, Colorado, all the time, writing poetry in his own blood, not caring if it rhymed, that he would later read to us so as we need not bleed ourselves to grieve, hanging out with the Beats, Ginsberg, Kerouac, Cody, and now Janine, discussing modern poetry over smoke and esoteric tea, and how beat the beat becomes in someone's heart now, missing you, as we on earth like dandelions twirling in a cosmic wind, waited on the porch for the rain to subside enough so that the puppets wouldn't melt in the children's performance upon the lawn,
that was planned for later on in the afternoon. I figured it out.
Obama.
Okay, it goes something like this. Okay. There is a room, a huge room. Inside the room are folding chairs, a room full of them, folded and leaning against the walls. There are enough chairs to sit each and every culture and race in America. One chair per culture. The room is large enough for each culture or race to unfold its chair and sit facing the other cultures and races, so that everyone in the room can sit and face each other. But why won't they unfold the chairs and sit?
Yes.
Because there is a huge elephant standing in the middle of the room. And the elephant is so damn huge that it would be impossible to open up the chairs and sit facing each other. But the elephant can leave the room.
Could you do your poem?
It's
your
poem.
Your turn.